If you've been following trends in the marine industry, then you've probably heard about lithium iron phosphate batteries, and they've really kind of taken the boating world by storm. Lithium packs a ton of power for its size. For example, here's a 12-volt battery, but it's 190 amp hour. Today, I want to give you a little walkthrough on how I powered this 1675 Lund, Alaskan tiller boat. This boat was purchased for use up at our family cabin. And one thing you'll notice when you look at this boat right out of the gate is we got some pretty big fish finders in here. Here's a Humminbird Solex 12. On the bow, we have two Solex 10s. And then we have a super legit trolling motor. We have the new Minn Kota Ultrex Quest. This is a dual 36-volt, 24-volt configuration, 52-inch shaft. It's brushless and it has a ton of torque. It needs a lot of power, but this boat is capable of running all this stuff in a boat that you usually wouldn't see this amount of electronics in. But we don't want to forego fishability and the ability to find fish quick just because we're in a smaller boat. That's the fun part of it. And with lithium, we can do this. Hop inside, give you a little tour. So for this battery rig out, we needed to start by considering the footprint of this boat. This is a utility boat. The Lund, Alaskan's designed for whatever you need it for. Fishing, hunting, maybe you live on an island, you got to haul a bunch of supplies back and forth. But because it's a utility boat, it's not equipped with all the integrated storage that you may be used to in a bigger boat. So I wanted to be mindful of trying to preserve as much index storage that I possibly could, and lithium was the solution there. First off, I started in the back with a 12-volt battery. We have a 12-volt dual-purpose Millertech, 190 amp hour. And what this dual-purpose battery allows for is powering deep cycle applications such as fish finders, trolling motors, as well as marine starting applications. So make sure that your lithium is compatible with cranking if you're going to use it in an application like this. This Millertech is. If you take a look in the front, you're going to notice two storage compartments. And naturally, you know, these are typically reserved for battery compartments. A typical configuration would be two 12-volt batteries in series to power a 24-volt trolling motor. This isn't a tiny boat. It's 16 feet, 10 inches long. I got a 75 horsepower on here, a decent amount of fishing gear. So 24-volt is the right application. But I didn't want to occupy both of these with 12-volt batteries. I wanted a single battery solution. Lithium is nice for that. I have a 24-volt dedicated deep cycle lithium battery here. This is a Millertech 80 amp hour. This is dedicated solely to powering this trolling motor, and I can run all day long with it, that single battery solution. And then keep this compartment in reserve for whatever I want, basically just extra storage. If I wanted to, I could run two 24-volt batteries in parallel, effectively doubling my amp hours and runtime, which is 80 hours, so I could make this into a 160 amp hour boat, which would be well over 2 days, potentially up to 3 days of actual use on the trolling motor. But this 80 amp hour has all of our needs covered with this boat. 190 amp hours is a ton of energy, has a very energy dense battery, but I did that for a particular reason. And it was after running through the calculation of my amp hour draw per hour on the boat. What I mean by that is this Humminbird Solex 12 draws about 2.7 amps per hour. Up front, I have two Solex 10s. Those are roughly 2.5 amps per hour. I have a Mega Live, 1 amp per hour. In total, that's 8.7 amps per hour just on fish finders and the Mega Live or forward-facing sonar transducer. I'm gonna round that up to 9. So let's say we're out for a 12-hour fishing day. 12 times 9 is 108 amps. That still leaves plenty of overcapacity or extra remaining power within this battery. And with lithium batteries, the best charge cycle is to come in and charge even if you have a lot of remaining capacity on the battery. But that's nice. Like, let's just say we're in a remote location. We're gonna go a couple days without recharging. Not a problem with this battery. Even though I have a ton of power, I still like to turn the backlight down if I don't need full light. We have cloud cover today, so this is gonna save quite a bit of power. When I get up front and I start fishing, I always put the back unit in standby like this, unless of course I have an angler in the back that wants to see that screen. So that's a way of just conserving some power while you're out, just to maximize time on the water between charges. One of the challenges with batteries in the past was knowing how much capacity you have left on that battery. Do I have enough power to go out and run that trolling motor or run these fish finders or crank this engine? I mean, we've all been dead in the water before, and it's a real pain. Millertech has a really sweet app that allows me to talk to both of these batteries with Bluetooth. The app is extremely easy to use. When I click into it, I'm going to reference down to the bottom here. I have device connection, control panel, and about. I'm going to start with the device connection and actually connect to my batteries. My batteries are listed here on the bottom. I have an MT24, that's our 24 volt deep cycle. And then here's our MT12, which is our 12 volt dual purpose 190 amp hour battery. All I need to do is touch on each. You'll see an outline go around them, and then it'll go from connectable to break. That means they're connected. Now I'm just going to go down to the bottom and touch on control panel. And now I'm going to get key information about each battery. All right, well, this is peace of mind for me. Our 24 volt trolling motor battery is at 93% remaining capacity. It's kicking out a voltage of 26.57, and I have 56 out of 80 amp hour remaining. Down here for the 12 volt, 91% remaining capacity, 13.19 voltage output, 173 out of 190 amp hour remaining. So that's a real peace of mind knowing that I can go out today without any issue. If I were to ever have issues with the battery, they also have this about section at the bottom. And here you have some contact information for the company, telephone, email, website, and the customer service is excellent. These guys are going to get back to you as soon as possible, usually within the same day if you don't reach them direct over the phone. A few other key benefits of lithium. They're about half the weight. That makes a big performance difference in boats of all sizes, whether you're running a smaller boat like this or a big, you know, multi-species boat or a professional bass boat. You're gonna notice that in your hole shot. You're gonna notice that in your top end speed. Size, they're significantly smaller than a lead acid or AGM battery that you would need to have that amount of power. So back here, this 190 amp hour battery is a typical group size 31. Huge amount of power and a small form factor. That 12 volt up front, that's another group size 31. And a lot of these lithium batteries, depending on your needs, are like a group size 24. So if you have a tight space, but you still need the power, definitely consider lithium. Longevity. Lithium batteries last a long time. These Millertechs are warranted for 10 years. A typical lead acid battery that's getting used quite a bit throughout the course of the year, 2 years maybe, and you're replacing batteries in your boat, maybe three or four on the, you know, extreme high end, that's a huge benefit of lithium as well. Another thing I want to point out with this boat is it's going to see use into the late fall months. If your application is going to have you out on the water when it's cold out, consider choosing a lithium battery that is compatible with charging when it's cold. Both of these batteries have cold weather charging capability, so we can hook this up at the dock when it's, you know, late fall and still get a good charge on them. And charging brings up a good point. Because there's so much capacity and we don't always go and fish for long days, you're oftentimes going to come in and still have a ton of remaining capacity on the battery. The best thing to do after each outing is to come top off your battery. So let's say we go fishing today, I come in, I still have 70% remaining battery capacity. These smaller charge cycles actually increase the amount of charging that you can do on this battery. So I don't want to run this thing down and totally deplete it. I want to go use it. I want to come back and just recharge it and top it off. We happen to have a battery switch in the back that will cut power to this battery, to that battery. So any Bluetooth protocols that may be connected to these batteries don't have the ability to trickle drain that battery, and they'll hold at 100% for a long time. You don't have a persistent battery drain with them. So just keep them topped off, and that's just one way to extend the life of these batteries. Another consideration when you're running an application that requires, say, 24, 36 volt system is to choose a lithium battery that's designed to output that, a single battery solution. So because of space, we wanted to, and need, we didn't need to go with 36 volt, even though this Ultrex Quest is capable of running 36 or 24. 24 was more than enough for us. And we just have room for a 24 volt battery here. Slide in this group size 31 24 volt in this compartment. But each of these lithium batteries come with a built-in battery monitoring system, which basically manages the internals of the battery to make sure that everything falls within a certain technical specification. The battery monitoring system is engineered to deploy 24 volts as efficiently as possible. So it's a more efficient way to get 24 volts than doing, say, two 12-volt batteries in series or three 12-volt batteries in series to come up with 36. So consider that, too, that battery management system. If I'm running two or three batteries, and if I were to have a cell go out and one of those batteries in the series, that's going to reduce the efficiency of my overall configuration. Now, in a big bass boat rig out or a walleye boat rig out where you have a 36-volt trolling motor, they make 36-volt lithiums as well. And what a lot of anglers are doing is running two, say, 36-volt or two 24-volt in parallel to double the amp hour rating or to actually have a little redundancy if something were to happen with one of those batteries. They can simply connect to one of those batteries and still have the necessary voltage required to power that piece of equipment. And one last note, keep these lithium batteries dry. While they are sealed in waterproof housings, water is not a lithium battery's friend. So we have them in trays raised off the bottom of the boat, and we have them in relatively dry compartments back here. So just keep that in mind. You don't want that battery to be totally submersed in water. If it takes on water, that can damage those lithium cells.